All right, here we go, guys. We got two Twisted Allure coffin bombs. One is the ectoplasmic, right here, exorcism, and it's a crisp apple fragrance. Two is the Michael Returns. These are both brand new bombs. She just put them out. They smell amazing. This is a crisp, apple-y, kind of real apple smell, and this is the best blueberry smell I've ever smelled. It's like, it's listed as like blueberry cobbler, but it just smells like nice, sweet blueberries. But I'm gonna do them together. So we're gonna put in the blue one and then the green one right behind it. So let's go ahead and plop him in. Oh, please just plop it gently. And now let's plop in Regan's. Ah, look! Oh, finally. It's happening. It's good. It's good. Okay, good. I got them to sit there nicely. They're doing what they're supposed to do. Don't. Regan, no, don't leave. She's going to a wall. She's going to find a wall. God damn it. They're both going to walls. Well, I got them together for a minute. Yeah, once that minute was up, it's like, no, we're going to move around. We're going to go travel. My best favorite, most perfect part of a coffin bomb is when the water slowly trickles in to the middle of the coffin and it kind of like poof, and breaks away. You'll see it. It looks so damn cool. It really is. Regan, hey, ectoplasm exorcist, go towards your brother there. Go. Now. They don't listen. I try. They don't listen. Look. Look at the top. Isn't this so cool? I so wanted to do them both together. I'm so glad you guys wanted to see it together. Wow, I gotta say, man. The blue that's coming off the Michael Myers Returns one. Whoa. Regan, the ectoplasm exorcist is kind of like a light greeny color. My light is washing it out severely. Unfortunately, that just tends to happen. It's a light greeny type color, so it would really kind of look like, you know, it kind of give you the effect of, remember when she puked up the pea soup? It's pretty much a great homage to the movie. It really is. I'm sorry, but it is. It's that color. Oh my god. Okay, so Regan is kind of overpowering the strong blueberry fragrance a little bit. I can smell a lot of that fresh, crisp apple fragrance. I can smell the blueberry, but I definitely smell the apple, like, overpowering. It's a nice, beautiful, it's like a Macintosh apple. Like, you know that real sweet kind of tart crispness that you get from, like, cutting or breaking a real Macintosh apple open? That's what I'm smelling. And then I'm smelling that a little bit of the blueberry in the backdrop. Well, depending on where I'm sticking my head, actually. But that is too cool. That's an Instagram photo. Instagram. Sorry, I'm so bad with my Instagram. I really am. I should be like posting a photo constantly, you know, every bath bomb I do. To tell you the truth, man, I am, there isn't enough for me to go around. That's the problem. I just can't get that much around that fast. The Facebook, I pretty much leave for just, you know, just bullshitting and talking and stuff like that and little tidbits and whatever, you know, if I really want to get something out or say something, I'll post it, but I barely post shit anymore. When I was younger, I used to mess around and post stuff on Facebook and then, you know, kind of learn that that's not your diary. But a lot of people haven't learned that yet. Like, there's so many people that, like, post very intimate details on their social medias, and it's like, don't do it. Don't give others ammunition. Just don't do it. And a lot of people just haven't learned yet. But Instagram, I try to, you know, get on top. I try to post some of the unboxings. I try and post little bits. But to tell you the truth, I screw up on Instagram so bad. I just don't get everything up. Everything that, like, I want to get up. I can't get it all up there. There's just too much. That's why I solely rely on the YouTube for you guys to know, you know, find the good. There goes the blueberry. Holy crap. Wow, that just punched me in the head. Look, he's doing it. He's doing it. Look, he's filling. There he goes. There he goes. All right, so the blueberry hit it first. He was the first one we laid down. Watch him just and break. Oh, there's the flood. There's the flood. Oh, he may drop down on me now. He may be waterlogged. That may be it. No, no, he's floating still. Damn. Wow. Oh, there he goes. He went belly up. He got too waterlogged. The water overtook him. He's spinning in there. He's going around. Look at him. He actually remained on the float. Do you know how hard that is to do with a coffin bomb? That is extremely hard to have a coffin bomb remain floating. Because once the water kind of logs into it, it's going to drop. It's just too heavy. Holy crap. Look at him go. Come on, Reagan. Your friggin' horror brother over here is beating you out. Look at the water, though. Look how cool that looks. This was such a great idea. I am so glad you guys wanted to see it like this. I love the idea of hitting the two bombs at once. Oh, look, here's the soap. The stuff that she pours on top is a melt and pour soap. Like the blood or the whatever, you know, like see how it's got the dark green on the top there? That is all the melt and pour soap. And when it breaks apart, if you have hot enough water, which don't do your baths boiling hot for a bath bomb, because you very well can heat out the fragrance oil. You can do that. I haven't really seen many people do it, but look, that is the melt and pour on top with a little soap right here. That's a soap as well. And it's just, wow, I am foaming. It's just, if your water's hot enough, it kind of will just disintegrate into the water. Wow, I gotta tell you, man, that's soft as hell. It will just kind of disintegrate into the water. And, you know, once sitting in the tub for a little while, you won't even realize it's there. Sometimes when you go to rinse down, you will, you know, you'll see a little piece of melt and pour from the top. Oh, there goes Regan. There goes Regan. There she goes. There she goes. Oh, she got the floods. This is so cool. I love my bath bombs. I do have a weird obsessional passion for these things. But, you know, you gotta look at it from a creator's point of view. These people are really breaking their ass. And it's causing them a lot of stress to make these things perfect for their customers. So, hey, they're really killing themselves putting them out for us to enjoy and have a great time. Then, you know, I'm gonna be as obsessive as I am with them. I think they're amazing little beautiful pieces of art. They really are. They're so cool. They bring me so much happiness. They completely de-stress my life. I really, really, really love watching a bath bomb go off. Just as much as I love sitting in it, you know? I will totally jump in and just lounge back and chill out in my bath. Like, just, you know, happy as a pig in poop. I think Boog's gonna sit this one out, because this is a mama bath. I want some mama time. Richie's off now, because, you know, we got that whole, like, you know, three-day weekend going on. A lot of people have Friday off. You guys may not be seeing this on Friday, though, but today is Friday. Sometimes I gotta do a little pre-recording, you know, just simply due to having appointments and things like that, and when I get a chance to do a bath, obviously you guys see it. But today is Friday for us, and we had a three-day weekend, and Richie is on mommy duty, so that mama can take a little break and get some stuff done. Like, I needed a little bit of de-stress. I wanted to chill out in the tub for a little bit. Yeah, I take maybe 20 minutes out of my day. And then it's back to wax working. I got a lot of cool stuff I want to do with the wax. But I just don't have time. And my now, you know, new restock date is getting pushed back. Simply because I just don't have the time to get it all out and get it all done. It drying wax takes a while. But I figured out the gummy bear molds. The gummy bear mold, I did do. Everybody was suggesting. One of you actually was suggesting. And as soon as I thought about it, I was like, wait. I can just pour it all on top, take the scraper, and because I have a soap cutter, and just scrape it down. And it'll fill all the little holes for the gummy bears. And that's what I did. And then one of you jumped on and said it. And then Natalie was like, hey, you know, one of your subs just said to just scrape it off with, like, a flat spatula. And I was like, I tried that. It worked. So, yeah, you have a very ingenious mind. And it worked, and that's how I get it done. That's how I get the wax into gummy bear molds. And they pop out perfectly. Absolutely perfect. Yeah, it really was kind of like a what do they call those, blessings in disguises? Look at the water, look at the water. Aw, my bug's just tired. I may just let him jump in and hang out for a little while. I kind of just wanted to decompress and relax. Ooh, look at the color! It's turquoise! I love turquoise. That's one of my favorite colors. Turquoise and pink. Because the majority of cartoon pigs that you see are pink. And I love pigs. I have a very unusual pig obsession. Pigs and bath bombs. Or bath products. Let's say bath products. Not store-bought. Created. The store-bought shit is garbage. I do from time to time buy store-bought shampoo and conditioners. But I rely on Beth. Nightwing Bath Body for her conditioners and stuff. I'm praying she comes up with a shampoo because her conditioners are kick ass. And like literally they're by me at all times, like that company. I love her conditioners. I haven't found anything store brand that's that good. Wow, this is a real beautiful kind of like mashup of the green and blue. I really love that. Instaham. You ever see Angry Birds? Instaham. So what do you guys think? Do you guys like it? I love it. I'm so glad we did this. I love the water over there, like the mixture of the green and blue. I am so glad. But you want to know what I'm going to do? I'm going to flick the water on to just see, you know, just what happens. Just out of curiosity, basically. I do have two chunks of soap in the bottom there. I have the Regan face and Michael's face down there. So I'll go fishing those out when I jump in. But, and then, you know, and then you use them, too. These are perfectly usable soaps. Usually what I do, because they're a little smaller, they're, like, maybe that big, I smush them into my loofah. And then use them that way. They're really good, too. They have the fragrance and everything. They're really cool. And it's nice to have a little something with your balm. Okay, so it's pretty much done. We got our photos and everything. We got our little still shots and the whole nine. Let me take one more here. Let's go ahead and turn on our water. So if you have the earbuds in your ears, yank them out now. And let's go. Yes, I know. You're all wondering, why do I have my faucet turned that way? I just felt like doing it. I don't know why. I mean, I can turn it any way I want, really. But I just kind of felt like doing it because I had my loofah hanging off it. I don't know. I just had that idea. This watercolor is what I have always wanted in a bath color. I love that turquoisey color. I think this is a beautiful color. I've always wanted this. And this fragrance that's popping right now, it is 50-50 apple berry. It's like apple blueberry right off rip. I can't explain to you kind of, oh look, we're getting bubbles. I can't explain to you kind of what the fragrance is. Because now that the real crisp apple and the real kind of blueberry smell, not synthetic-y whatsoever, mixed together, I don't know what to call it, but it's pretty damn good, and it's sweet, and it's fresh, and it just smells really good. Look at my water. Tell me that's not real pretty. Oh, look, it's got glitters in it. Ooh! You see it? You see all the little lusters? It's loaded with them. Very, very, very. Ooh, it's so pretty! And I am getting like a nice amount of bubbly foam. So I bet you if I had some really damn good water pressure, or if I had jets. Oh! I'm telling you, I'm just going to go to someone's house that has jets in that round bathtub, which I found another YouTuber that has them, man. I forget her YouTube name, but she's really sweet. She's cool as shit. And, she actually started her channel from watching, Xper means someone else. But I was like, oh, wow, I'm so honored. You know, like, I don't think any of you guys even know. Pay attention, you know, when I do this shit. I just kind of do it just so, you know, for the hell of it. Look, I'm getting bubbles. Look, sorry, I'm just trying to It's like really bubbly. Okay, so I'm watching her channel, and she has that round tub with the jets that when I had my house in Florida, before I moved from Florida to come back home, man, I love that tub. But I had the same tub. It was round, beautiful, it had the jets. And anytime I did bubble baths or even just squeeze some shampoo into the bathtub, which I know y'all have done it because I've done it, to make some bubbles, I would flick on those jets and have a hell of a time. And I literally wrote on one of her videos, "Can I come take a bath at your house?" And I meant it. I am one of these days gonna go rent another hotel room like I did when I set off the King Tut bath bomb for the Mad Bombers. I really wanted to set that one off in, like, a jacuzzi, and it was beautiful. And I have that video up here if you ever want to see it. Just Mad Bombers, King Tut, Corinna Grell. There you go. Poof. Find it any way you want through that way, but it's here. It's on this channel. I rented a hotel room to use a jacuzzi to do it. I don't know. I did, like, four or five, like, Twilight bombs and then that bomb in it. And, man, those people were pissed because that jacuzzi was extremely slick. And it was very hard for those people to clean. But... because you're not supposed to put anything like that in the jacuzzi. They supply you in those hotels with, like, a little bottle of bubbles. And fuck that. I went, had Lush bubble bars, Twilight bath bombs, the King Tuts. I went nuts. They were mad. But that's why I did it in a hotel room. And we had an amazing night just chilling out in the jacuzzi. Boog swam around. He loved it. It was so much fun. And one of these days, I am going to do it again. If I ever find the money. Kids are expensive. Kids are very expensive. Every time he turn around, they need something else. So, I guess until he's 18 or until he's 16 and go get himself his own job. Yep. We're gonna have to keep trying to save up for our little dreams there. I think that's beautiful. I wish my light wasn't washing it out so much. But there are sparkles all through here. It's so pretty. The color is gorgeous. It's so gorgeous. Like, I want to turn off my flash right now, but I would have to stop video, turn it off, come back. Like, it's a pain in the ass. It's so beautiful. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed. If you've enjoyed and you want these bombs, Twisted Allure, baby. All you got to do is hit the description down below, scroll down, hit Twisted Allure, and go shopping on her Etsy shop. Also, find Twisted Allure at Twisted Allure on Facebook and Instagram, and you will find out all the new updates and new stuff that's coming out and everything. If there's any kind of problems with any shipping, if shipping seems abnormally high, feel no fear in contacting the owner. Lisa is a very sweet, kind, generous person. Amazing, amazing, really nice person. And don't feel awkward at all if it seems abnormally high. Etsy does have some weird issues. And just like every other company, sometimes, you know, it gets a little high and it's due to Etsy just adding it up the wrong way. So if it seems abnormally high, and I'm talking like over 13 bucks, then, you know, like over 13, over 15, especially, say you put in two products and it's like, what was it, two products and it's like $22 for shipping or something like that, Etsy's adding it up wrong. Just contact her and say, hey, is this right? Shit, sometimes it may be right and sometimes it may be wrong, but it's always good to ask. Because if you want the products, you really want to go ahead and get your money's worth. So you really want to make sure that Etsy hasn't screwed up on their shipping, which happens with a lot of places, unfortunately. I have contacted 6 Etsy shops getting boxes and things like that for my own company. And out of those 6, 4 of them had shipping problems. And I did contact and say, hey, is it normal to spend 30 bucks and get 30 bucks in shipping? And they were like, oh, God, no, not for what you bought. She was like, I can put it in a flat rate envelope if you like. I was like, sure. So I paid $7.20 in shipping. You know, like, it was just like, you know, a lot of them were like, oh, God, no, that's not right. And then they recalculated it, and I got correct shipping. But you got to do things like that, you know? You got to just please don't be embarrassed, you know? It's not like the person can see you on the other end. You're not physically speaking to them. You're typing. So don't feel shy. Don't feel embarrassed. You're behind a screen. It's okay. I love yous all. I hope you enjoyed seeing this. I really enjoyed pulling it off for yous. I'm so glad it came out, went off without a hitch. And, like, I didn't sink them, and I didn't, like, throw them in, you know? Like, it was so nice. I really enjoyed this. I may attempt to do this again with other bombs and things like that. I like doing them from the same company and watching them kind of, like, twine into each other. I think that's so cool. So if you enjoyed, please give me a thumbs up. Let me know you're liking it. And we may do more of these double features. I love you guys. I really missed you guys when I was gone. And I'm glad we're back in the swing of things. And I can't wait to do like some nail videos and play around with some stuff and have some fun. And who knows? Maybe we'll go live. Maybe we'll do. I always said I don't want to do YouTube live. Maybe we will. I don't know. I'll let yous know though. I love yous. I'll talk to yous all soon. Bye.